Confessions. One on the way. These are my confessions. Look, don't be fronting. Y'all do the same thing. When y'all don't be knowing the words to the song, y'all be trying to... And then you wait till you get to the part where you know the words, you try to sing it. But no, I got a confession to make. Before we even get into this video, before we even react to this video, your boy did something, man. Your boy did something. So look, it's funny, right? So yesterday, right? It's hilarious. It's coincidental. Hilarious. Yesterday, I took his shorty out to eat, right? We ain't going no steak 48. It wasn't nothing big. The bill was like, I ain't gonna lie to y'all. The bill was like $25, $26, $27, right? So when I go to pay the bill, right? And now we ain't go to no Mcdonalds. We actually went to like a sit-down place to eat. When I went to pay the bill, shorty was like, hey, do you want me to split the bill with you? I just started laughing, right? Because y'all know I do these reaction videos and these niggas be talking about 50-50 and gold. I just started laughing. I just started thinking about shit. I was like, nah. I told her it ain't nothing but money. I ain't worried about it. It's just money, right? Anyway, thought that was hilarious. Anyways. All right. So, if you're new to the channel, man, make sure to hit the like button. It's free. Make sure to subscribe to the channel. It's free also. Make sure to share the video. It is free. And make sure to hit that bell and turn on post notifications so you're notified every time we drop. And that's free also. So with that being said, call me what you want to call me. I know all the black people, all my brothers, y'all, all my sisters. I hate saying that, but you know what I mean? Y'all should have hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, even click the bell to turn on post notifications because as niggas, we like free shit. It is what it is. But anyways, man, since they want us to believe, before we even get into that, if I have reacted to this video before, make sure to leave a comment in the comment section once we get to the reaction part of the video, right? So if I react to it, let me know. But since they want us to believe that their content is real, we're going to react to their content like it's real.
Guys, do me a favor, man. I need y'all to go over, follow me on Instagram, Damion Cryer Sr., all lowercase, if y'all want to see me keep pimping, picking these females up and exposing them. Anyway, let's check this chick out, see what she on right here. Ooh, she thick as hey, beautiful, beautiful, how you doing? What's your name?
I don't got time.
You got MySpace or anything?
MySpace?
Yeah.
No.
What's your name? I'm Damian.
I don't know what you got.
My hands are like.
I'm not gonna talk, no.
I can't even get your Instagram or nothing?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry to bother you, ma'am.
Cool. You have a nice day, though.
Have a nice day, ma'am. Sorry to bother you. No problem, ma'am. Wow, that really hurt my feelings right there. She looked like such a nice, beautiful, innocent girl, too.
All right, so he couldn't pull that, so that lets us know that you're not a pimp because you could pull that because clearly a pimp, a player, hustler, baller, whatever. Well, I'm going to take the remaining ones I named out, but clearly a pimp knows how to communicate, knows how to speak, and knows how to persuade a individual, whether it's, whether it's a male or a female, you know what I'm saying? Clearly they know how to persuade. So clearly we know you're not a pimp. Clearly we know you just got a suit on and playing a role because you couldn't get that one. Just saying. And she ain't got no damn ponytail. Y'all be, boy, we'll roast her ass up. She ain't got no ponytail. Like them type bras, whatever, especially the ones that think they bad, like nah, I'm good, I'm cool, boy. But you can't handle it all, they steal all that shit, right? And they got like a little nug. Here's her, they got that little nug right here, that's their hair right there, this little nug right here, you feel what I'm saying? And you tell them to do like this, and they nug don't move, it just stand still, like bitch, you ain't got no ponytail. You can't even get smart, and your hair can't go that way, this way. Like, sit down. Sit your ass down with no hair. Sit your ass down somewhere.
Ooh, man. Yeah, excuse me. Hey, what? Yes, ma'am. Can I help you?
I know you had this part.
Of course you didn't know I had this car. You didn't give me a... Stand over here because this traffic is crazy.
Well, I just... I don't know. Like, your outfit. It don't really match what you're riding in, so.
Yeah, this one of my cars. I mean, why don't, I mean, what my outfit don't match? I mean, I'm
trying to look like you're walking to the bus or something. I don't know. I know.
Hold on. I'm wearing a $25 outfit.
I'm not gonna lie, you don't got that one, but I do like your car.
So you trying to tell me that I'm not him?
We can work with that. Like, we can fix your outfit.
Are you the same lady who was just on the sidewalk a minute ago who didn't have time for me?
Well, yeah, but that's because I thought you ain't had no car.
I mean, what's your name anyway, since you
back? I'm Michi.
Michi, I'm dang, but yeah. You can call me daddy.
Okay, we'll talk about it.
I want you to call me daddy. I mean, you was kind of rude. Call me daddy.
Daddy.
I like it. Now, can I get a spam real quick? Because you was real foul over there. So where you headed to? You married? You got a dude or something?
Not that you need to know of. I mean,
not only is you young and fine, but you got a smart mouth too. I like it though. I think it's kind of sexy.
Thank you.
I'm just saying though, I was going to offer you to get in and get up out this heat for a second. But if you got a dude, I ain't trying to get shot out here in the street.
Nah, it's cool. Gang on
trip. Okay. You ever been inside a Rolls Royce before?
Yeah, like once or twice, but never a white one.
You never been?
All right, breaking news. Whatever clock news channel is where you live at. Old man stands outside on the sidewalk trying to persuade and con women to enter a rented Rolls Royce only to kick them out and cause a disturbance. So the whole point of me saying that is like, what is your whole purpose? Your whole purpose is not to expose any woman because clearly, like I said, you can't expose somebody who's basically see something nice that they don't have and they actually come back. That's not exposing anything. Now, a different story is if she had her own... Different story is if she had a Rolls Royce. Different story is if she had her own bread. Maybe you can expose her for being a fake rich motherfucker or something. But you can't expose... Here's the thing. You can't expose a broke person for being a gold digger, especially when they broke. You can't expose them. Because, once again, there's a line. And the line is, okay, they're broke, they see something nice, they're going to go back for what they see nice. On the other hand, it's like, okay, they're broke, they don't want to go back to being broke or dealing with broke people. This is an opportunity for me to deal with somebody who got something. Cool, I will take that chance. So you can't really expose broke people, y'all, for being a gold digger, especially when they've been broke their entire life. And I'm not talking about broke, as far as homeless broke. I'm talking about $600-$700 and you're trying to finesse $600-$700 so you can pay this bill, pay that bill, do this, do that, and have $100 or $200 left to your name. I'm talking about that broke, right? So understandably, bro, she came back and you're speaking to her only just to try to get her in your car. Now, remember, you got the pimp suit on, so you still must remain a pimp, but you're not doing anything that a pimp would actually do as far as... Matter of fact, I take that back. Because nowadays... These new age niggas that think they pimping, this is the shit they do. So I take that back. My fault. We ain't in the 90s or 80s, 70s or whatever. To them niggas is real live. Bitch, shut the fuck up. You know what I'm saying? Nowadays, these niggas let the bitch drive the car while they sit in the passenger side. And I don't mean literally drive the whip. Like, for niggas who know what I mean, you know what I mean. They let them, they be the car rider in the car while she's the driver. And they say they the pimp and control and everything when obviously they not. But yeah, so this is what it looked like to me. You just trying to flex your muscle. You just trying to show, hey, you got a Rolls Royce. Hey, come on, Rolls Royce. Come on, man. Yeah, you got a dude, anything I didn't know about. Come on, man. Okay, well, your dude ain't got a Rolls Royce. Come on, let's get in the Rolls Royce. And for all you people that don't know Mr. Organic, he says something on that No Jumper podcast. He says something... I know a lot of y'all probably do know Mr. Organic or probably heard of him. If you ain't, check his shit out. Or check his No Jumper interview out with Sharp. He says something that really stuck out, and this is something that these cats do, right? So you can't say I'm a hater when I say this. He said he was doing rich lame nigga shit. Like he was calling girls up, talking about, hey, when you gonna come? When you wanna come by around a Rolls Royce? Hey, you wanna come by? Hey, you wanna come by? Kick it in the something square feet mansion? And you know, I got our 5 supercars. You know, he said that to him was lame nigga rich shit. And we gonna say whether he got it now or he don't got it, the nigga had it. You know what I'm saying? The nigga had the big ass mansion in Malibu. The nigga had the motherfucking 5 or 6 supercars. So he had it. But he said that's rich nigga lame shit. Told y'all I wasn't hating. Told y'all I'm just trying to get y'all some game. But anyway, let's see what this square ass nigga gonna do in this video.
Here is this.
Brand new, 23, baby.
Oh yeah, it looked like a 23. I like to be in this one though.
Yeah, stars in the ceiling, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, okay. I love the stars, you know what I mean?
I'm liking what I see too. You look very, very nice, very, very attractive.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So let me get the door for you.
Okay, yeah, you can get the door for me.
You said your name was again?
Michi.
Michi.
Yeah.
Michi got it going on. That door for you, girl. Hop on up in that thing.
Thank you.
Hop on up in that. You welcome. Hop on up in that thing,
girl. You got the red seat.
Absolutely.
Nice.
You look nice too, isn't it? Probably faking everything else, bro. Let me see what she on though. Big H. You good and comfortable over there?
Yeah, I like your seat.
Oh, thank you. Thank
red,
you.
My favorite color.
Favorite color too. Them cheeks just suck those beautiful cheeks right on.
Well,
that
I look
too.
Good in it, huh?
Cheeks all soaked up in the seat. I got the little massages on it too.
Yeah, I can feel them too.
Yeah,
real good.
They got the automatic massages. So, you know, I know you said that I didn't need to know all that out there outside the car, but I would like to know what you got to do because I'm not interested in him, but I'm interested in you, and I want to know.
No, I don't got to do.
No.
Ex, but he ain't had no Rolls Royce, so.
Yeah. I mean, he ain't really need to have a Rolls Royce to be a good man, though, right?
Yeah, that is true, but, you know, I'm always looking to upgrade with who I'm dealing with, so.
Okay, I mean, you ain't the type to swap him up out, though, right?
Not if you try me.
Try you like how?
Like, not if you ain't on the.
I'm never on. I'm like, I try to keep it real because, you know, that's what I expect. You know, I'm looking for a really good woman, somebody, you know, that can match my vibe and stuff. You say that you can help me dress differently and stuff to match
my
roles.
Yeah, for sure. Because, you know, it just don't really, right now, it's not really on the same page, but I could help balance it out.
So this is not giving?
It's not that. You don't got that. But we can put you in. So what do you do? What's your occupation?
I'm a businessman and I'm something like a pimp.
All right, so let me get this right. You got a pimp outfit on with the hat, the cane, and everything, but you're not pimping. You clearly let a shorty tell you that your outfit's not it, and she clearly says she'll help you get your outfit together, this, that, and you asking her and you communicating with her about your fit. here we go. So do you want to be a pimp? Or do you want to be a regular person looking for a nice woman who wants you for you? Because outside of the car, you was a pimp. You was, you know what I'm saying? Inside of the car, you're turning into, inside of the car, you forgot that the role you had to play was the pimp role, right? So now you've turned it into a different type of, like, come on, man. Turns a different type of person. The confusion. Oh, the confusion, but it's okay. That's why y'all got me here to react to these videos for y'all so y'all can actually see straight through this clown-ass shit. It was a pimp outside. Now you in the car, and you're not doing nothing pimpish. You're not, you know what I'm saying? So, but we'll continue watching, man.
Sound like, yeah, a pimp.
Yeah, I'm something like a pimp.
Okay.
I mean, not like...
It must be lucrative. I mean, you in the 2023.
I do very well too. I mean, this ain't the only one I got. I got other toys too.
Well, like
the Lambo.
What?
No, I got a few other items. Vet.
Really?
Hummer. Wagon. I got a few other things. You know, like doing what I do right now is not all I do. I actually do real estate too. I buy old buildings, break them down, section them off into parts, and sell them to insurance companies and stuff like
you,
that.
So you him for real, huh?
I mean, I'm trying to be him. I'm trying to see if you heard of. I mean,
and I'm definitely in.
So tell me about yourself, like, you know, what type of stuff you like to do.
Well, I'm into a lot of stuff, but I mainly like to shop. I travel a lot.
Oh, okay. You like to shop. Cool. Like, what type of stuff you like to go buy?
I like JPG. I like Como de Garcon. I like
You know me at Walmart, stuff like that, shopping at Walmart. Like, I'm just saying, like, they got some nice stuff there. They really do.
I wouldn't know. I don't even go to Walmart for my groceries.
All right, so we're going to stop it right there. Now, I don't care how much money you got. I don't care about any of that. Everybody shops at Walmart. Now, a millionaire, they may not actually go into Walmart and shop. They may shop online in Walmart. They may send somebody to Walmart with some money, but cut it out. 95, 96% of our population shops at fucking Walmart. It is what it is. People need to stop fronting. She's saying all of these, I like this, I like that, I like this. And here's the thing. You like this, you like that, you like this. You're going to have a different attitude. See, that's what people don't understand. Even though they be like, oh, money changes people, money does change people to a degree. Some people can handle it. Some people are still themselves, but a little bit different. But for the most part, money can change you. Now, to the person who's never had money, let me give you $100,000. I guarantee you, you're not going to be moving the same way you're moving now. I guarantee you, you're going to still be yourself. But at the same time, you're going to have added extra additions to your character, which is you. You're going to be, you're going to add some different type of stuff on. So cut it out. If you're saying all the expensive stuff, all the nice stores, I do this, I do that. But you still got the ratchet, broke, dumb mentality. Sums up. I'm just saying. Only motherfuckers who keep that ratchet mentality is niggas who constantly get it. Now, you've been constantly getting bread for years. I'm not talking about 1-2 years. I know niggas who've been getting bread for like 15, 20 years, my nigga. So, if you know motherfuckers who've been constantly getting bread that long, some motherfuckers will stay ratchet. Some motherfuckers will keep their inner hood, all that stuff. But for the most part, for a motherfucker who is just, and I didn't contradict myself, I'm just saying, for the real money, real paper. We ain't talking about just came just a paper two, three years ago. No, been getting paper since you could start hustling, 12 years old type shit. But here's the thing, man. Shorty clearly does not have the vibes of paper. She clearly does not have the vibes of I have money. She clearly does not have the vibes of I'm sitting on 100 G's or plus in my bank account. She has no vibes of I get big bands. She has no vibes of none of that. So cut it out with the nonsense. Cut it all the way out with the nonsense. You're not slick.
Oh, you high maintenance.
I wouldn't say that. I just don't go to Walmart.
Oh, we go to like H-E-B.
H-E-B cool.
Yeah, you like shrimp and crab legs and stuff?
Yeah, I like oysters too.
They say all bad ones love seafood.
Yeah, and do.
Yeah, so tell me about the shopping thing again though, so I can get a good
idea. I don't know, I just like to shop. I like a lot of designer. I like, for my bags and stuff, I love Chanel. I don't know, if it's, I just like designer period. Like, yeah. I don't really stick to one brand, but if I like it, then I want it.
You ain't the type of female that like on like the first week or two of dating, you don't expect like to go out and cash out all this money. Like you wait like a couple months, right?
Well, I would like to be courted. You know, I love gifts. So,
all right. Another thing is, here he goes with it. So you know, you like to wait a couple months before you go out, start spending money. You're not the type of female who wants it up front. Only women that want it up front are the women who's putting out, bro. If a woman's strictly like, no, you got to buy me this, you got to do this, do that for me, you know you're getting some action. You know that's her MO. You know she goes around and fucks around with motherfuckers and niggas trick on it, niggas spend money on it. That's how you really know if a bitch is a trick or a bitch is a bitch for you. So if you meet a bride, and I'm telling you right now, I don't care what you say, you can say all women want to do is spend money, do it, blase, blase. When you meet them, they ain't going to talk to you. You ain't talking about spending no money. It's a damn lie. See, and another thing is, those are not the women that you want to be with anyway. If a woman is demanding, you go out and do this, you don't want to be with that bitch no way. Those are the wrong type of women. See, the problem is a lot of you motherfuckers choose the wrong men, and a lot of y'all choose the wrong type of women. You know what I'm saying? Oh, you may see somebody who look good, and then what do? You go buy you an outfit, look fresh, then you may try to holler at her, you may get the number. Okay, let's go here. Then what you do? You try to impress her by going to some expensive-ass restaurant, doing all this extra shit, right? those are not the women you want, bro. You don't want them types. Them is the women that you basically may take out, fuck around with, and then that's it. Because that's all it's ever going to be. You want the motherfucker who wants to just go walking apart on the first day. Let's go walking apart, man. Or y'all meet up somewhere in the parking lot. Speaking of which, y'all meet up in Walmart parking lot. You either hop in her car, sit there and talk to her for an hour or two, or she hop in your whip and you sit there and talk to her for an hour or two. Those are the type of women that y'all want. You don't want the women. You want the women who don't need to be in a setting of spending money in order for them to have a good time and get to know you. See what I'm saying? So quit falling for the women. Well, hey, this club popping, we can go to this. Quit falling for them type bitches, bro. And y'all know what I'm talking about. And y'all women know what I'm talking about too. Y'all keep falling for them type particular people. And what happens in the end? You're sitting there how you sitting there now. Mad at the world because she didn't cheat on you. Mad at the world because he didn't cheat on you. Yeah, I'm talking to you right now. I'm talking to you directly, looking in the camera, talking to you. You mad right now because you can't trust your girl. Her phone went off. She won't be all sketchy with her phone. She leaving at odd, weird times. And then vice versa. You'll be mad at your dude because his phone going off. He keep walking around the house with his phone. And when he lets you use his phone, he stands there and watches you. And vice versa. When she lets you use her phone, she stands there and watches you. See, y'all chose the wrong one. You chose the one that is in the social media a little bit too much. You know what I'm saying? Just saying, man. I'm trying to give y'all some game, man.
Well, yeah, of course, duh.
Yeah, but, like, I mean, come on now, like.
I mean, if we dating for, like, 2 or 3 months, like.
2 or 3 months, that's, like, 2 or 3 months too long before I'm getting anything.
No, you would get something. Like I said, Walmart has always got, like,
awesome.
Child. You ain't never had they perfume. They got, man.
What? No.
Walmart got some pretty good stuff in there. They do.
Well, I'm not interested in nothing that Walmart got. Let me just say that.
I'm just saying, but I wouldn't do you like that. We would go to stuff like we would go places like restaurants and stuff like that.
Restaurants like what?
Well, first of all, don't knock it till you try. Jack in the Box got these curly fries. I swear these things is like you got your choice to get curly fries or regular fries.
Okay, hold on. What type of girl you think I am?
A beautiful young lady.
A beautiful young lady that want to shop at Walmart and eat Jack in the Box?
I'm not saying all the time. I'm just saying, sometime.
No. I mean, come on now, like, don't play.
That's not playing. That's better than sitting in the house and doing nothing, right?
Well, I'm not sitting in the house and doing nothing when I'm by myself. So if I'm with you, I want to do the same thing I'm doing and then better. Come on.
Well,
now.
We are going to do eventually. They're not online, but I'm just saying.
What you mean, like, what? That's not a 2-3 month probation period. I need that right off the bat.
I mean, so is you going to do something for me off the bat?
I mean, you with me.
I mean, I am with you, though.
You ain't with me yet. You want to be with me. So why would I have to wait 2-3 months to get nice? Like, come on now.
And another thing is, the average person is not tripping at Walmart, y'all. They're not, okay? So don't look too deep into the video, because I know the haters. See, and the reason why I call you guys haters to make the comments, because your comments are biased. They're not really opinionated. It's like, okay, well, I expected you to say that. That's why I say y'all are haters. That'd be a different story. It'd be a different story if you was like one of the supporters on the channel. Because believe it or not, there's motherfuckers who've been supporting the channel since I started doing this. They like every video. They leave comments in the comment section. And they had their own mind. They had I disagree with you on this one. And they say what they gotta say. And I can't do nothing but respect it. Why? Because that's an honest opinion, but their honest opinion. That's not a biased opinion. That's not a, I like Damion Cryer, I don't like Wallz, so I'm going to say this back. No, they watching the video honestly, and they're like, I don't agree with that, which is fine. But that's why I say, once again, you haters, it doesn't make her a gold digger because she's complaining about Walmart or Jack in the Box. Who wants to eat some greasy-ass fucking fries? Like, people don't analyze it all the way through. If I'm going to eat some greasy-ass food, I'm going to go eat a motherfucking fajita or something like that. It got fucking grease in it. I'm not for eating no fucking greasy-ass fries or no greasy-ass hamburger. Like, nobody's doing all that shit. And once again, here we go. You putting a person down for them not want to clog their damn arteries up off the fucking grease and shit from the fries. You know what I'm saying? Like, come on, man. Knowing good damn well, you clog your fucking arteries up by eating all that fucking bullshit. If you eat it for a long extended period of time. You know what I'm saying? But anyways, but like, come on, man. Like, can't be serious. Can't be serious. But we about to continue watching and reacting to this nonsense.
So what I gotta do, pay a toll?
No, but you gotta do what I want. Well, at least I expect that.
Well, maybe I'm not hearing you clear enough. Okay, then what do you expect, Tamika? Right, Tamika, right?
Tamika? Who the fuck is Tamika?
What's your name? Laura?
Michi.
Michi, I'm
Laura,
sorry.
Laura, who is Laura?
I'm sorry.
I ain't one of your lovers.
Whoa, where did that come from? I talk to a lot of people on the phone.
Nah. You just said you somewhat of a pimp. I'm not one of your lovers. You're not going to call me all these different names and then try to feed me in Jack in the Box. I don't even eat Jack in the Box on my own. I am.
And gold digger. That's exactly what you sound
Excuse
like.
Because
the way that you cussing and talking crazy. I'm like, yeah, you trying to gold
First
digger.
First off, I don't sound like that.
I'm trying my best not to hit my mother.
I'm trying my best not to smack the fuck out of you because you really got me fucked up. A gold digger.
Ooh.
Yo, she want to talk to me and expect I'm going to eat some Jack in the Box? What do I look like? I mean, come on, be for real. Yo, in this perfect outfit, you don't got that shit on. I tried to help you out, put you on some shit. You probably don't even know what JPG is. Oh yeah, you looking at me like you stupid. Don't call me a f***ing gold digger. Come on now, be so for real. And I, hello?
You said you were gonna smack the f*** out. Can you just open the door and just please get out the car?
Why would I get out the car? You was just trying to talk to me, now I gotta get out the car?
Please, I would like you to get out my car, ma'am. Just. I don't want no trouble with you. You seem thugged out.
You just disrespected me, asked me if I want some Jack in the Box, want to shop at Walmart. They finna call me gold digger. You walk around in a purple outfit, driving a Rolls Royce. Gonna ask me if I want something under $10.
Okay, enough. Get out my car.
Now you finna cuss at me? You just wanted me in car, not finna get out the car?
Yes, the knob's right there. Just open the door.
You gonna have to put me out there at this point because you really got me. Up. And you look at him smack at you and take it.
Oh, no, you gotta go.
No.
Or reach over
you. Don't touch me. Look, whatever, man. You in that purple outfit, so you need to get a stylist.
Go get a real booty. But y'all hear this chick talking about smacking the out of me, bro? Her whole tone changed, bro. She's a gangster. A Houston queen gangster.
So that was an interesting outro, interesting take as far as Tamika, as far as her saying she's going to smack the hell out of him. And just basically saying, keep it in 100. Like, you know, hey, nigga, old nigga, basically. Like, I mean, what do you think? I'm just about to just be hopping on your shit? Don't know, bro. It has to be something more than just you trying to be nice to me. Because I got a lot of guys that been trying to be nice to me. I know a lot of guys currently that are nice to me that will continue to be nice to me because we friends and shit. But the way that she did it, man, the way that, oh my goodness, this shit crazy, bro. This shit crazy, man. I ain't got nothing else to say, bro. Y'all do me a favor, man. Like, comment, share, subscribe, man. And we out till next one.